RCAP solution start working assisting Manzanilla, who had like a big problem with their waste. There was a cleanup, more than 500 people show up.
My name is Edwin Vasquez. I work for RCAP Solutions. After the cleanup of Manzanilla, we've received many referrals for areas that have been impacted with salt waste. And one of them was the condition of the lake. Guayabal is a reservoir. It was made in 1912 for the supplement water for the agricultural operations in the south of Puerto Rico. It's been one of the most important lakes in the south of Puerto Rico because it's been providing water to agriculture in Puerto Rico.
RCAP Solutions serves Puerto Rico in many different ways. Solid waste is just one of the topics that we cover here on the island, but there are also lots of needs in water and wastewater as well. So we provide training and technical assistance in all three of those major areas to really support overall community development.
We received an approach from the municipality to evaluate the condition of the lake, and then after that, we talked with the PREPA, the Puerto Rico Power Authority, who is the owner of this lake, and they were being able to provide us all the information and assistance to evaluate the situation. This lake has been affected severely for trash and illegal dumping in the river, so it's been accumulated in the lake for so long. And the accumulation of this illegal dumping in the edge of the lake has been affecting the operation of the lake that is providing water to the south of Puerto Rico.
Cuando se nos acerca el señor Edwin Vázquez de RECAP, para nosotros fue como una oración contestada por la capacidad que ellos tenían de poder entrelazar los esfuerzos interagenciales del pueblo y de la comunidad y de grupos también que sin fines de lucro, que realmente para nosotros era casi imposible.
We found refrigerators, we found any kind of materials that you wouldn't imagine, 505 items collected manually to understand what kind of material we're dealing with. We include the schools because education is an important part of this problem. We include the police department because they have something to do with the illegal dumping. And we've been dealing with the situations, including the community and all the parts. It means churches. It means every people that related to the living things that promotes the growing of trash and solid waste.
Mi nombre es Ernest E. Pagan Ortiz. Vivo en el barrio Guayabal, en la cercanía del lago Guayabal, en Juana Díaz, Puerto Rico. Edwin llegó un día a las puertas de mi casa, al portón. Él me orientó, no solamente de desperdicios sólidos, sino de la tierra, de la fauna y de la flora. Y eso pues, me animó de continuar, ¿verdad?, mi esfuerzo, no solamente como individuo, sino crear un grupo de trabajo que él está dando un seguimiento continuo para mantener esta área en progreso, constante progreso.
Un trabajo extraordinario, sobre todo gracias a RECAP Solution, que se llevó a cabo un ejercicio con diferentes instituciones, tanto públicas como privadas, para orientar, educar a nuestra gente, reconociendo el trabajo de esta gran institución, donde se envuelven las comunidades y su gente en aras de que tengan el conocimiento pleno, ¿verdad?, especialmente en cualquier desastre, y la limpieza, sobre todo, que se deben mantener los embalses de agua, como es un lago, como son los ríos.
Small communities in the area of solid waste management have been impacted because of the creation of a lot of illegal clandestine dumps that have affected rural areas. We saw it immediately after the hurricane. Little by little, municipalities have been able to clean up those areas, and it's basically actually the communities that have led those efforts to clean those illegal or clandestine dumps. Puerto Rico lost more than a year of landfill capacity due to the amount of the debris that was generated. Working with partners such as RECAP Solutions to start identifying potential initiatives. Puerto Rico needs to expand its recycling markets and its recycling programs. Currently in the island, there's close to 10 to 12% of recycling, which is very low compared to other localities in the United States and in the world.
We're really trying to work with people to understand the whole concept of reduce, reuse, and recycle. At the end of 2016, they passed the plastic bag ban, which I think was a huge victory for our staff and for the island to really help reduce some of the plastic that's going into the waste stream. And we've been spending a lot of time since then providing reusable bags to students and community members and really kind of explaining to them, you know, where that came from and why it's important.
Y sobre todo es bien importante que las comunidades se envuelvan en este proceso. Es bien importante que las comunidades creen conciencia lo importante de mantener sus comunidades limpias.
They're proud of what they did in that area. There's a lot of need of education. This is something that if we don't pay attention now with solid waste, you know, we're going to end paying.
Quisiera que mantuviéramos siempre la comunicación porque esto no es de una vez y ya, sino esto es de todos los días que tú tomas agua, de todos los días que hay vida. Si no lo ayudamos todos los días, algún día pues esto perecerá antes de tiempo. Queremos vida y tenemos que estar todos los días en comunicación para llevar a cabo este progreso continuamente.
For more information on solid waste planning in your community, including funding and technical assistance, please contact us.